Hello YouTube, this is Dakota from Bowtied Media, and today we've got a brand new edition of This Week in EDM, where we go over songs that came out this week in EDM. The puppy decided he wanted to join for this one, so he's going to and help me talk about 30 new songs that came out this week. As always, there is a Spotify link down below for all the songs for easy access, if Spotify is what you use. And let's hop into it with the bad category, songs that I thought were not great. Remember, this is just my opinion, do not take them as gospel truth. We've got Vicetone featuring CVBZ with, Little Bit of Your Light. Vicetone is truly a shell of their former selves at this point. This track sounds so dejaded and disheveled. This is, like, there's so little life, energy, or anything to draw you back to this track. The melody is also quite sad. Not a fan of new Vicetone. We got Laidback Luke featuring Marlonbeats with One on One. Generic tech house with kind of senseless dance music lyricism here. No reason, again, to really revisit this track for any capacity. Then we got MEDUZA, HEVOLVE, and Beanfield featuring Bajka, I want to say, with Tides. Not really sure the point of this track is that it really doesn't do anything. The drops are anticlimactic. The verses are pretty much just filler. It's kind of a boring track with a linear structure. I don't really get the point of this one. So then we've got Clean Bandit, Anne Marie, and David Guetta with Cry Baby. Oh, boring, generic, flatly mixed slap house with equally boring lyricism here. It's radio bait and it's not worth your time. Don't bother with it. As we're moving into the meh category, songs that I thought were pretty meh, we've got Automhate with Rave Operator from the double-sided single that just came out of his, and it's two tracks of very heavy Britom that really just isn't my flavor more so than anything. The melody is pretty linear, and the sound design just doesn't, it doesn't feel like it's up to the typical Automhate standards that I typically love from his style of production. Then we've got Baauer with Fueled by Yogurt, a short track that has a driving anthemic production to it, which is cool for like a soundtrack of like a villain entrance in a movie or something like that. But it's nice in that aspect, but not really like a song. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't really feel like it's a song that you would actually just listen to. It feels like something in of a movie. But then we've got Tobu with Faster, a little surprised how generic I think this track ended up being. In all honesty, I haven't really listened to a lot of like modern Tobu, this feels like a far cry from the tracks that I used to jam to of his all the time. This feels like relatively lifeless and outdated, and it almost seems like he tried to make himself more serious as a producer and kind of lost some of his charm along the way. So yeah, not a fan of no new Tobu. Then we got Delta Heavy featuring Hayley May with Never Alone, the sixth and final single from their upcoming record, and it's very much Delta Heavy. Pretty standard song structure and production, all things considered. I'm very intrigued to see how this record plays out, because I thought some of the tracks were pretty generic, and I thought some of them were some of their best, and I just don't know where we're going to land record-wise, but that's that. Then we got Slippy and Josh Rubin with Crash. Slippy with some dance floor drum and bass on NCS with this new release. I don't think it's necessarily a bad track by any means. I just don't think it's very Slippy. It's not really in his sweet spot of his production elements. I also got like a Eurodance final drop, and I just think that's even more so not necessarily his style that I think he excels in. The song is kind of just is and has very little defining features of what I typically listen for in a Slippy style track. So that's that. Then we got Arcando featuring Felix Samuel with Ignite, a pretty standard dance floor drum and bass tune with a prominent synth melody. The whole track is fairly jumpy and meant to get you moving, but I do think it is kind of fairly generic, all things considered. Another kind of more generic dance floor drum and bass one. Then we got Conro and Zack, Martino with Brighter Days, another bright, summery electropop tune with big stutter house drops and happy synths from Conro. Very feel good, just like a, put on the car and get driving style track. And I thought it was just meh, though. And then we got Just a Gent with Everything Will Be Okay. As always, super creative atmosphere from Just a Gent, as this kind of like weird mixture of house, trap, future bass, some tech in here. For Just a Gent standards, though, I think it's fairly tame and definitely could have used some vocals on here, I think, for sure. They've got Exod featuring Adelaide Adams with Remedy, a nice and bright melodic bass track with great vocals from Adelaide here specifically. Otherwise, it's kind of a fairly by-the-books, more generic melodic song structure, but otherwise, I thought it was okay. Then we're moving into the good category, songs that I thought were pretty good. We've got Vizen with UFO, another lively electro house tune for Chompo that is unique enough to kind of stand on its own, but fits perfectly within their Chompo ecosystem. So I liked it. Then we got the Mazare remix of Hold My Breath, originally by Set the Sky and Boys Like Curls. I very much prefer this remix to the original, I must say, as Mazare kind of ups the tempo and energy of this remix. If anything, I think it's kind of that added guitar element, that electric guitar that really adds this track and sends it to another realm more so than anything, especially on that back end. Then we got Alan Walker featuring Blood Nymph with Beautiful Nightmare from the new Neon Nights EP from Alan Walker on Monster Cat. A light liquid drum and bass tune with a big kind of Eurodance synth melody. Blood Nymph's vocals feel very Alan Walker in that they're very light and airy and a touch nasally, I would say. But I do think this is easily my favorite track from the EP. I feel the EP is interesting up to this point. I don't really have fully fledged opinions on that up to this point, but this is definitely my favorite part of the EP. Then we got Sultan and Shepherd and the Kite String Tangle with Memories, a beautifully atmospheric progressive house tune. One of my favorites, I would say, from Sultan and Shepherd as of late. I really appreciate the vocals on this and specifically the 6-minute runtime that really lets the progression stand out and lets it actually progress. Then we've got Bayswill and Grape Milk with Meta Construct. Very unique and playful track with lots of little sound design elements that add up for like brilliantly holistic listening experience. These two producers are very relatively small, but they make this track sound like they're pros. Stylistically, it's like a chill melodic rhythm, kind of really just an amalgamation of a bunch of different styles, and I really enjoyed it actually. Then we got Nufori with Andromeda, a atmospheric hypertrance that has got to be one of my favorite Nufori tracks yet. It's got this kind of picturesque soundscape with this kind of audible imagery of like flying through the clouds with no care in the world. You just feel like, but it's still got that like driving hypertrance beat to it. It's a pretty fun listen for sure. Then we got Must Die with The Light. Definitely a stronger track than his last. Must Die really has his ups and downs. And so far, and this track, this is an upper for me. It's got a squeaky dubstep sound in the first half and a hard techno finale. And both, I think, work great and are some of Must Die's better production elements as of late. Production sounds, I should say, as of late. Then we've got Zedd featuring Remy Wolf with Lucky. This was an interesting one for me. I didn't love the first single, but this one, it was a greater improvement. It sounds a lot like kind of Zedd's 2017, 16, 18 style of this kind of like funky house and very bassline driven instrumentation. I do think it's a touch short, I will say. I like the vocals a lot here from Remy, but I do think the song is a little short. Otherwise, it would have been higher up. Then we got Effin with Trouble. The acoustic guitar fake out into distorted melody was insane on this track. Even having those kind of two parallel layers of the kind of pure acoustic guitar and the distorted production side by side work together really well. And just having that kind of raw acoustic guitar sound all throughout really gives more kind of gusto to the electronic elements and makes it feel like it's packing more of a punch than it maybe deserves to. Then we've got Shallow and Night Tales with I Just Want to Dance, a carefree moving house cut with tons of little disco elements all throughout. It's not a track with a ton of energy, but it really gets you moving and wanting to dance. Then we've got Hesh and Beast Boy with Watch Yo Mouth, some of the most sporadic, off-kiltered, bizarre rhythm I've heard in a hot minute. And I enjoyed it all, surprisingly, because I'm not a huge rhythm fan. There was this inherent sense of power that came with this track, and the kind of added trap beat and funk synths for the off-drop sections paired quite magically with kind of bassline lacking drops, which was a very interesting stylistic choice where there was very little low end in the drops, but it just worked. Then we've got Tynan and Viscous with Do It Again from the new Good Music EP from Tynan, a 3-track EP. And Tynan cooked. He cooked on this track. The kind of happy synth melody on the first half and the absolutely crushing production on the back half were a 1-2 combo of Tynan's best production styles, I would say. So really enjoyed that. Then we got Chasing Status and Stormies with Backbone. I'm not particularly a fan of the vocals here, but I do think the production is absolute gas. I saw someone compare this to kind of a mashup of Badadun and Liquor and Cigarettes, and I would have to hard agree with that. But yeah, the vocals are a touch too hot, I'd say, in the mix, but otherwise the production is more hard-hitting DNB from Chasing Status that we all kind of know and love. And we've got Affinity and Ari Kemmler with Ready Now. Affinity has kind of slipped back into some old habits with a more bass-centric dubstep tune. and it's nasty. This might genuinely be one of my favorite Affinity tracks to date. The drops are crunchy and overall like beautifully chaotic. I honestly wish there was more, an extended final movement and or a whole nother one. This was one that I thought was really, really great. So way to go, Affinity. Then we've got Chime with Prosper on a new double-sided single of Prosper and Micrology that just came out on Disciple, where Chime answers the question, can you make a tiny drop? And the answer is yes, indeed. I'm very intrigued to see long-term down the road how much I often will listen to this, but more so than anything, Chime just showcased that he can make tiny drops and do it really well. More so than anything also on the drops, that very added, like the very intense added sustain to the bass line is what keeps the drops feeling tiny while still not very much like a gimmick. It makes them feel like there's some oomph and some power to them, is that just kind of baseline sustain. So really like that, those two, I should say. Then we got Evan Gaia and Memba with Stamina from the new Stamina LP out now from Evan Gaia. And yeah, this is a kind of buzzing hybrid trap sound design with really unique production elements. I love Evan's vocals here and absolutely adore what Memba did on this track. Some nasty production, some of the best I've heard in Memba for a while, so really enjoyed it. And my number one song of the week is in Standout. We've got a top song in Standout that is above the rest, a cut above the rest. We've got Turquoise Death with Hold Tight. Turquoise Death has been, grinding the atmospheric drum and bass sounds as of late, and it's paying off. This might just be their best track yet. It's very dreamy, serene, and genuinely feels like it transports you to a higher plane of existence. And this is fantastic. I'm so excited for the new album from Turquoise Death coming out eventually at some point. So, but that has been This Week in EDM. Let me know what you think of all songs, any and all songs in the comment section below. But other than that, I'm Dakota from Bowtied Media, and I'll see you guys in another video.